All right, so what do we want to talk about first? The good news or the bad news? Because we got a little bit of both. But I could never be more proud of a group of guys for the way they competed in a game, the way we competed in the second half. But, you know, the message going into the game was don't give the other team anything. You know, play with poise, execute, do your job, stay focused, you know, throughout the game. And there were times in the game where I felt like we lost our poise a little bit. And but in the second half, we competed and did a fantastic job. Jalen played extremely well. We were able to move the ball offensively, even though we had to throw it. Couldn't run it very well. But the tenacity that our players showed, the competitive spirit, the resilient attitude to overcome adversity, a lot of which we created for ourselves. You know, having 14 penalties in the game, mismanaging things in the clock at the end of the game, you know, really gave them opportunities that, you know, we need to be able to fix those things so we don't help the other team. We helped the other team on their last drive to kick the field goal. We had two penalties and a missed tackle, and they're right down the field and score in no time. So we have a lot of things to clean up, but we have a lot of things to be proud of. And I'm really excited about just, you know, the team effort. And, you know, we weren't at our best in the first half today, but for guys to pull themselves up, to overcome adversity and resiliency, and this is a great win for our team. It was a great win for the program. It was a great win for this team. You know, it was an opportunity for this team to sort of show who they are in terms of what kind of team we have. And I think we can have a really, really good team. I just think we self-inflicted wounds are going to be something that we can resolve because they're all fixable. And we certainly need to do that if we're going to be able to compete at a high level in the future.
Coach Burton had a great game, almost 200 yards, two touchdowns. With this program, coming back for a senior year, being patient this year, is that kind of what you've been preaching to have a game like this?
Yeah, I mean, we've always had a lot of faith, trust, and confidence in him. He's a big play player. He's been bothered by a little foot injury for a while, didn't play much last week. He's back to 100% today. And, you know, it was our plan to, you know, try to, we knew they were really good up front and we would struggle with their front. But we felt like if we could protect well enough and get some time that we could make some plays down the field. And I think that's something that we did very effectively. And obviously, he was extremely effective in the game at making some big plays.
Chase, over on the right.
Coach, I want to ask you two things. First, how big was the safety in the fourth quarter? And secondly, you mentioned some bad news. Did you already bring that up with the penalties?
Yeah, I brought it up with the penalties and mismanaging and, you know, all that. So, this may be the record game for me in terms of messing up and still winning. Might be a record. You take the mess ups and the penalties and you add them all together. But then you look at the other side of that is what kind of resiliency and ability to overcome adversity does somebody have when you're talking about the kind of competitive spirit you have on your team. Which I'd take that any day because we can fix the other stuff.
Chris Lowe in the back.
Nick, how much does this team rally around Jalen, in particular his ability not to let one bad play become two or three after his pick? He played lights out the rest of the way.
Yeah, and I think that's one thing that, you know, Jalen has learned. Just keep playing the next play and focus on that play. You're going to make mistakes. Bad things are going to happen sometimes, but you got to be a point guard, man. You got to make lots of assists. Not very many turnovers, but you can't let the turnover that you do make bother you. And distribute the ball to the rest of the guys on the team and let them to make plays. And I think he's doing a really good job of that.
Katie up front here.
What did it say about the defense after both turnovers on offense if they were able to get y'all the ball right back either with a turnover or the blocked field goal?
Well, I think the turnover when we turned it over and then Caleb Downs intercepted the ball, that was kind of the changed the momentum of the game. And I think the fact that we were able to keep him out of the end zone and play good in the red zone was really, really important early in the game, as well as, you know, it's a little different if they score a touchdown in the end. But we allowed them to go down the field in two-minute situation because we got two penalties and, you know, gave up a big play. And we had several guys that could have made the tackle. So, but I'm just proud of our guys and the way they played, man. It's a great win for us.
Nick Alvarez, I was wondering if you had any updates on Malachi from
games. Malachi's got a twisted ankle. Who else?
James Burnham.
He's got a pulled muscle in his leg.
Mike?
So.
What led to Jaden Roberts starting right guard today? How did the offensive line handle kind of having a new guy in there?
Well, obviously, we had a tough time running the ball, but they lots of pressure. Which we were able to take advantage of, making explosive plays down the field. It's hard for me to say how he played, but, you know, Dalcourt had a little shoulder problem, so he was struggling a little bit. So, you know, I thought 77 went in and did a pretty good job.
On the left here with Kennington.
What did you see from Trey Amos when he stepped in?
Yeah, that's really tough. Trey did a good job. He got the one penalty for holding, but, you know, he did a really good job while he was in the game. The bigger adjustment is for Terrion, who goes and takes Malachi's place when Malachi goes out. And then Four goes in the game and plays. So it's a lot of changes. And, you know, it's hard to practice two positions as thoroughly as you need to be able to go in the game and execute. And when Malachi first went out of the game, we made some mental errors because of that. But I thought both guys did a good job of adapting in the game, and the other players around them really helped them play well by communicating well.
Finish up over with Ross.
Nick, you said this might be a record game for messing up and still winning for you, one of your teams. What does it mean that the team did that? What does it mean that what they can do maybe later in the season?
Well, if we can fix it, I think that, you know, we could be a very good team. You know, the injuries are starting to mount up a little bit. So there's going to be opportunities for other people to step up, and how well they do that will, you know, be a huge determination, because I don't think we have any easy games coming up. A lot of tough teams in our league, a couple good quarterbacks coming up. So we got lots of challenges. But if we could look within ourselves and fix what we need to fix internally ourselves and make a commitment to doing that and pay attention to detail, to the details that matter to winning in a game. That's what we need to do a better job of.
All right. Thanks, Coach.
All right. Thank you.